Hello guys, this is Revant. Welcome back to Tech News Episode 3. This video is sponsored by Finoptis Infotech. It is a team of professionals providing end-to-end web designing to software development and also digital marketing services to the business. If you want to know more about their services, the link is in the description below. Xiaomi going to launch the Redmi Note 10 series in India in March 2021. According to earlier rumors, Redmi Note 10 comes with 120Hz Full HD Plus LCD screen and the processor Snapdragon 732G. And it comes with 6GB RAM and a 64MP quad camera setup and a 5000mAh battery. And it supports fast charging as well. Redmi Note 10 Pro 5G will comes with 120Hz Full HD Plus LCD screen and runs on Snapdragon 750G or 765G. And it comes with 8GB of RAM, and there were no rumors about the Redmi Note 10 Pro Max version. Full specifications will be known at exactly launch date in March 2021. Redmi K40 and K40 Pro received TINA certification ahead of its official launch. There are some rumors that it comes with triple camera with 48MP rear camera and a new Snapdragon 870 chipset. It comes with 4500mAh battery with 6.81-inch AMOLED display with 120Hz, and it also comes with 12GB of RAM. Nokia launches its two smartphones, Nokia 3.4 and Nokia 5.4, and it also launches their true wireless earbuds, Nokia Power Earbuds Lite. Nokia 5.4 comes with 6.39-inch HD+ display and octa-core processor Snapdragon 662. It comes with Android 10 and we can also upgrade till Android 11. It supports a 4000mAh battery with 10W charging adapter. Nokia 5.4 will be available from February 17th on Flipkart. It has two variants, 4GB RAM, 64GB storage available at ₹13,999 and 6GB RAM, 128GB storage available at ₹15,499. Nokia 3.4 comes with 6.39-inch HD+ punch hole screen. It runs on Snapdragon 460 processor and it comes with 4GB RAM and 64GB storage. Nokia 3.4 is available at ₹11,999 on Amazon and Flipkart from February 20th. Nokia Power Earbuds Lite comes with an IPX7 underwater resistant, can withstand 1 meter deep water. It comes with a 600mAh and comes up to 35 hours of playtime. It comes with a Type-C port of charging and cost is around 3,499 Indian rupees. Poco M3, in their first sale, they sold about 1,50,000 mobiles. Next sale is on February 16th. Poco X3 Pro will be arriving in India soon, so they are planning to drop down their price less than 30,000 to compete with their competitors Realme X7 Pro and Xiaomi's Mi 10i. OnePlus launched a new battery replacement program for selected MacBook Pro models sold in 2016 and 17. There was an issue in the Mac OS Big Sur 11.2.1 update. The issue has only affected a very small number of customers. Whosoever get a notification, they can only eligible for battery replacement. Xiaomi's new gaming smartphone Black Shark is prepared to launch at least two phones, and these phones got approval from Tena. Tena's new microblogging platform Kuu gonna be a Twitter's alternative. Kuu is a 10-month-old platform came to a fame by winning the Bharat App Innovation Challenge last year. Kuu is been using by all our central government ministries. It is available in Android and iOS. It has all new features similar to Twitter. Kuu downloads grew up to 4 times in last 6 months. OnePlus X co-founder Callpay has started his own company called Nothing. Callpay said that Nothing will unveil wireless earbuds this summer. Nothing got an investment from Alphabet's VC arm. They raised about $15 million. Molecule launches their air mini purifier in India for ₹37,999. It is designed for rooms up to 23 square meters and good for apartments, bedroom and home offices. They have used a Pico technology. It destroys wide range of airborne pollutants. Pico filters has UVA light that destroy the molecular bonds of virus and bacteria. It is an ozone-free technology. Lenovo Tab P11 Pro tablet is going to launch in India on Feb 12th at 12 noon. It comes with Qualcomm Snapdragon 730G processor with 4GB of RAM and 64GB of internal storage. It will be having 11.5-inch 2K OLED display and it also loaded with 8600mAh battery. Chrome OS is bringing up the new feature that they soon support mirroring your phone screen. It allows user to access notification and control their phones right from their Chromebooks. WhatsApp is bringing up the new feature that it will support multi-device soon. You will get a new logout feature available on your mobile. WhatsApp gonna release on their linked devices in iOS, and companies testing two types of multi-device support. 6G war is brewing between US and China. Let's see who gonna bring it first. Apple Maps is testing the new feature that we can report accident speed checks and similar to Google Maps and Waze. This new update is currently limited to latest iOS 14.5 beta release. SBI is offering home loans at 6.8% and SBI is not charging any processing fee till March. Thanks for watching this video. If you like this video, please kindly like, share and subscribe to DigiIntegrity.